Today, we're taking a look at what you can build with Frontly AI, my new favorite no-code web app builder. Hey guys, welcome to another episode and happy 2024. So today I want to go over a Frontly AI. It's a no-code builder, quite similar to software.io, but I don't see a lot of people talking about it. It's, I think, a bit newer than software and all the other like Bubble, Flutterflow, and so on. And what Frontly focuses on is they have an AI assistant that helps you get started. It's never enough to like build a whole app, but it's quite good with like giving you the initial blueprint and helping you think about how to structure your app. So the way it works is it uses Google Sheets as a backend, and that's where all your data is stored. And then they have like different blocks that you can use to build out pages. I think it's mostly aimed at internal tools, so building internal tools for your business. But I'm also right now working on a project that's supposed to be external where users can register. By the way, this video is not sponsored. I just got the tool off of an AppSumo deal and I really love it, so I wanted to share it with you. And they have a completely free plan that you can use to start building. The only limitation is that you cannot publish a live app, so you can only preview it and build it. And if you want to try it, I have an affiliate link down in the description. And if you use it to purchase a plan, it will help the channel a lot. So I'm going to show you what you can build with Frontly, and we're going to take a look at their editor. But before that, really quickly, I don't know if you know, but I recently started a newsletter, and there's a link in the description below. It's free, and I write about business, tech, like things like that. And yeah, check it out. You can always subscribe if you don't like it. So let's move over to my computer and see what we can do with Frontly. Before I show you how Frontly works, I want to show you what you can do with it. So I have two examples here. One is a fundraising, like a CRM for fundraising, which I built internally for our startup, magnimetrics.com. It's intended as something that we'll use in-house. So as soon as I log in, you see here I have funding rounds. I can select those, and it's going to show me a Kanban with only have one lead right now, but it's going to show you where each of those leads are, and you can drag them around like a typical Kanban. Then you can do things like a calendar. So I have a calendar here, and our idea is that we add new meetings where we can select the investor or the lead from the drop down here, and then add a meeting link. So that way, if I set up a meeting in Zoom or Teams or Google Meet, regardless, we'll have everything listed here in a single calendar. And we also have a list of investors. So we see here we have some investors that have put in some capital. We have leads here, and as we open an investor, we get all the details here and all the representatives, and also a timeline for when we did what. This is where we can lock our interactions. So we can pick an investor, pick a relationship event. So what happened? So did we send a message? Did we receive a message? Call happened, things like that. Then we have a list of contacts which can be assigned to investors, and here we have our funding round. So that's a pretty robust fundraising CRM in my opinion, and I think it took me about 2 to 3 hours to build it. And that's the beauty of no-code tools, is that you can easily build robust and I'd say scalable in the most part internal tools. So another one that I want to show you is something for my YouTube channel. As you know, I have a few courses on Udemy, but I don't really enjoy being a creator on the platform anymore. You can read more about my beef with Udemy in my latest newsletter issue, link in the description below. So what I wanted to do is I want to host my own courses for free, and I came up with the idea hosting those in a Frontly app. So what I have here is people can sign up and log in, and they're going to see the courses. Of course, this is just some dummy data for now. And I also have like the course administration. So this is something that I see. And this is where I can create courses, edit details, things like that. And I can open the course, and I have a placeholder video here. So the idea is that they'll get like the course intro and then a list of lectures. And here, once again, lectures administration. This is just for me, where I can include new lectures and their video URL in YouTube. As soon as some they open a lecture. Again, here it will be the video from the lecture, and I'm currently working on figuring out how to do a status, if the user saw it or not. And it's a bit more tricky because I want it to be separate for each user. You have to figure this one out. But then we have resources, which are like URLs to files and things like that. And I can add them here from the administration section again. So I have title, then a link to an uploaded Excel file, and that's it. Now, my idea is that here people will be able to sign up, log in, and watch the courses for free. And hopefully, if I figure this out, they'll be able to track their progress. And the best part about Frontly is that this whole thing is run from a Google Sheet. So you see here, I have my course. Here I have the lectures with the video URLs and the course ID. Here I have resources. An empty table, supposed to be resources. And this is what's linked to my Frontly app. And this is how I'm able to show this UI and everything. And it's a really, really simple way to quickly build like different apps, especially, let's say, I'm not gonna go into our fundraising tracker database behind the scenes, but it's an Excel file that I already had. So I just uploaded it to Google Sheets, added a few like ID columns, and that was it. I already had the structure in my head before I started building the UI and the functionality and everything. And that's another benefit of those like no-code builders when you use them for internal apps specifically, that you usually already have like the format, the structure, and you only need to present it visually. So it's a bit better, and it allows a bit more control over who can access what and things like that. Okay, you might have noticed that it says Frontly.ai, and that's because it's supposed to be like an AI app builder. So I want to show you that, and then I'm going to show you the interface quickly. I'm going to hit new app, and you see here they have some templates, and we're going to say create with AI, YouTube video project tracker. Yeah, not going to provide any more details, although I was nowhere near the 1000 characters limit. So let's submit this one. That's how it goes. So what we have here, project in progress, not started, completed. Yeah, it's pretty basic. So we get projects, and then for each video, apparently we have the video itself. I usually use this only to generate a few iterations and just get ideas. So not gonna be using this one. Let's go back. I'm gonna open the Minty Courses app that I showed you here, and I'm just gonna go over some of the pages just to show you how easy it is to set everything up. Starts with courses. So what we have here is this is a basic like a grid with cards. Usually everything works like you list a spreadsheet that you want to be portrayed, and then you have some click actions, some card settings, like badges, styles, and things like that. You also have pretty robust filters in terms of if you want to filter a hidden filter. So if you want to, let's say, make sure that the user is a specific user group, or if they have like a paid plan tag to them, things like that. So you only show those that the user is allowed to see. You can also add visible filters. If you have more content, people can filter, and they can also search. Then advanced, you can tweak a few things about the editing and things like that. And you can also add permissions for editing, deleting, and creating. And even though I've hidden the buttons here, I'd still say that the user has to be owner. User is owner is true. So that way only I, being the owner of the app, can edit anything. And here I have the same thing, but it's a table. Again, the courses, and here we have a record click action. Remember here, it was a custom action. And what this custom click does is navigates to a page and passes a bunch of information. I'm using it as URL parameters. There's no privacy issue. So that's the easiest way for me to just pass everything in the URL and make sure that I get everything there without dealing with custom states and things like that. Probably not the best way to do it, but the easiest one for me. This second one, what I have here is the record click action is go to default view. and you have a default view, custom view, and so the custom action. So default view is an editing view that opens up, and you can also build this view customly, but then you don't have the option to delete, which is something that I've raised with the Frontly team, and they said that they'll look into implementing it at some point. But for now, just using the detailed view. And what this means is that you can click that and you see this form that you can edit. That is gonna pop up when I click any of the records in this table, and I'll be able to adjust from here. And you see the delete button here. If I want to, I'll also be able to delete it. That's how everything works pretty much. So from the courses, once you click a course, it will take you to course lectures, and it will get everything from the URL. That was the easiest and fastest way to do it. And it will get the video, the description, the subtitle, the course name, and it will list the lectures. And it's the same thing here. I have a table that I've linked the lecture spreadsheet, and I have hidden all of the fields, just need the lecture title. And if I click on it, it's gonna do the same thing. It's gonna take me to a page for the lecture, bypassing all the required arguments as URL parameters. And I also have the similar admin table here, which is the same table from up above, but with all the bells and whistles for adding a lecture. And also when I click on something, I get the edit detail view. And here I can only change the title, the URL, the course ID is just displayed. I've made sure that if I click on it, it's disabled because I don't want it to be able to switch a lecture to a different course. And also have the delete here. That's the course lectures page. And then if I go to the lecture page, when I click on any of the lectures, it's the same thing. It gets everything from the URL, shows the video here. This is something that still trying to get to work with some custom variables. And then we have the resources and another administrative table where I can add resources, exactly the same logic. I have here the detail view where I can have the title of the resource and the URL. And then I get the lecture ID from the URL parameter. And that's basically it. You just pile on different components, link them to a spreadsheet, and that's mostly it. And you also have, like, if you exit here and go to Google Sheets, you have the spreadsheets that you have imported. Pretty neat thing is that you can edit relational data. Because let's say in Airtable, if you're using software, you can set up the relationships in Airtable, but I always found that a bit like janky for me. The nice thing here is that as you have your tables here, you can say which column from which table matches a column from another table. We're building relationships really easily here. So here I'm saying that the ID of courses should match the course ID in lecture. And that's how I'm building all my relations. That's allow me to link all the different data points between the different tables. There's a lot more that you can do here. You can do some branding, change the primary color, play with your navigation, reorder, add sections, move it to the side, get the authentication. You see here that I've disabled signups for now. And this is a really great feature, is that you can go to users, add users manually, and disable signups. So only the users that you have added will have access to your app. There's a bunch of other tools here. We can change texts, labels, and things like that. And another thing I wanted to show you. So if you click here and the more, you can see all the blocks that they have. So they have, let's say for data display, you can do a table, a grid, a Kanban, timeline, map, calendar, info list. And keep in mind that for software, for example, if you want to get a timeline, you have to be like on a really expensive tier, which makes no sense for me. Same with the Kanban, you have to be on one of the more expensive tiers to get it, which makes no sense. Then you have forums for user input, layout, so you have like a row, which stacks things to the side, columns, stacks them vertically, different predefined layouts. Then you have like text, rich text, buttons, you can add charts, different stats, and also images, videos, and iframes. And in other, there's like a quote calculator, never used it, no idea what it does. Quite a lot of blocks that you can use. And I gotta say, being on this platform for the past like 3-4 months, I've already seen so much progress in terms of features that they've added, in terms of fixing bugs really quickly. Before you go, I want to mention one other thing. That's the best support that I've received from any of the no-code tools I've tried, and I've tried a lot. The other day, I did some, I don't know what, but I did something with my user settings, and I was unable to log in into the live app. And I was at the point where I was gonna like rebuild it, but I reached out to support, and in a few hours they managed to find the bug, fix it, push the updated version, and I was back in. So great customer support, great customer experience. And if you're in the market for a no-code tool, especially if you wanna be building internal tools because you don't have so much control of how things look if you wanna be building something external. But if you're looking for an internal tool builder, I strongly suggest you give Frontly a try. And yeah, there's a link in the description below, which is an affiliate link. And if you use it to get a plan, it will help the channel a lot. That's all I had for you today. Here's a video about using make.com to build automations within your daily workflows. Thank you guys for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you're not already, and maybe even punch the bell icon to receive notifications every time I upload a new video. Till then, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.